Taiwanese director Tsai Ming-liang is known for his slow, meditative cinema, but the story of his approach to filmmaking is directly linked to this man, Lee Kang-sheng. Lee has starred in every one of Tsai's feature films. An untrained actor at the time of their first collaboration in All the Corners of the World, Tsai found him on the street, sitting quietly on a motorbike outside a Taipei arcade. Tsai approached him and asked if he would be interested in auditioning for a role in his new film. At first, Lee didn't respond. He just waited and waited until finally agreeing. Tsai didn't intend for Lee to appear in all of his films, but during the making of Rebels of the Neon God, Lee came down with a strange illness that led to a severe neck injury. Tsai felt responsible for the injury and would accompany Lee to the doctors repeatedly over this time, and the two grew very close. In Tsai's third feature film, The River, the neck injury was used as part of the film's narrative. We see Lee's character struggle through the pain of the injury, giving us an insight into what lengths he might have gone through to find a cure. The River also gives us an insight into their working relationship. Tsai has stated that during one scene where Lee was meant to cry but couldn't, he struck him twice in the face to produce the tears. In What Time Is It There, tears were more readily available. Lee's father had not long passed away. Again, Tsai brings a real moment from Lee's life to the film as we watch him mourn the death of his on-screen father, Miao Tian, who had also played Lee's father in Rebels of the Neon God and The River. This shift in more realistic filmmaking in Tsai's work came from an altercation he had with Lee on set. While trying to complete a scene, both men had grown restless. Tsai thought Lee was moving too slow, and after reshooting a few times, he finally said to Lee, "Can't you be a little bit more natural in your movement?" To which Lee retorted, "Well, this is how I naturally am." Tsai realized at this moment that he may have been misrepresenting reality in his filmmaking, and that his job was not to force actors to stick to the script, but instead to work with the individual actor to bring out their most natural self. In this scene here, we see a perfect example of Lee's natural rhythm. When he interacts with another performer, it's not that he doesn't react to them. His reactions are just slow. Filming Lee's face became something very joyful for Tsai's filmmaking, and in the span of 20 years, we have watched Lee grow before our eyes. Lee has been the face and body of Tsai's films, but he says it's Tsai himself that is the lonely and withdrawn figure in the films. In Lee, Tsai found a vessel for his filmmaking. He found a trusted collaborator, and ultimately, he found a friend. Without Tsai Ming-liang, we would be without some of the most individual, personal, and frankly, best films of the past 20 years. And according to Tsai, he would not have continued to make films without Lee Kang-sheng, which surely makes their collaboration one of the most important in modern cinema.